Ken here from Property Stories, and in this video today, I would like to share with you some of the ways that you can buy property with minimal capital. Before I go on, if you're watching this on YouTube, smash the subscribe button, smash the like button, and please share this content to your friends and family if you find this beneficial. The first and the most obvious method is of course to do some markup. Markup here refers to putting a S&P price higher than what you actually bought. I give you an example. Let's just say you managed to negotiate a property price to $400,000. But when you do a sales and purchase agreement, S&P, put it at $500,000. And then when you apply for a loan, the bank will refer to the S&P price of $500,000. And if you are eligible for a 90% loan, $500,000 times 90% will yield $450,000, which is more than the price that you bought. So in effect, this property is a zero down payment deal. Number two, and the most obvious one, is to buy from our fellow developers. Developers will usually offer you rebates and discounts up to 10%, so you don't have to come out a single down payment. Some even offer you more than 10%. And then this will result in you buy the property, you get cash back. These are called cashback deals. So you can look at those if you have minimal capital. The third one is to negotiate for lower down payment. If you are buying a completed property, usually completed property, the down payment is 10% of the purchase price. But here you can negotiate with the owner. Let's just say a down payment is $50,000. Perhaps you can negotiate the owner, just say, is it okay to take a lesser down payment, maybe $30,000. I only have this much, and maybe the owner will agree $30,000 for this down payment for this property, instead of $50,000. Next one you can consider is to ask for freebies. What I mean by freebies? A lot of people actually take for granted, thinking that sub-sales, you can't ask for freebies. I will say why not. In sub-sales, you can also try to ask the owner. Let's just say, okay, you can agree on the price, but are there any freebies for me? Maybe you cover my loan agreement, maybe you cover my S&P, something like this. These are all in sub-sales. One thing that you need to remember is that everything is negotiable. Depends on how you talk to the agents, and also if you are dealing direct with the owner, it depends on how you deal with the owner. The last one and the final one is of course to do a multiple submission or compressed loan or concurrent submission. There's a lot of names there, but it means just one thing. It means here that you buy a few properties at a time and submit a few banks together. So all of them will yield a 90% if you still have the quota. Then once this yield 90%, you instead of buying two properties at 90%, you maybe can buy three or four. Okay? So this method will actually limit your capital that you need to use. But this method is a double-edged sword, and the central bank has been clamping down on this a lot. I do not recommend this. I do not recommend this. And if, let's just say, you are doing this, watching this and doing this now, right now, you are taking the risk on all yourself, okay? That's all I have for this video. I hope to see you again in the next video. Once again, this is Kenny here from Property Stories. Bye-bye.